Writing is on.
So fun. So we thought we'd just get it started with just a real basic, you know, we're all obviously moms and dads trying to juggle all of our schedules. So we just spoke to you a little bit about, but we always find it fascinating when there's working parents that are so involved in their children's lives and trying to find the best way to do it.
Well, both of us are actors, which is difficult. In fact, my son really doesn't want me to be an actor because he says, I don't know when you're going to be around. And even though actually I'm probably around more than most dads, most working dads, he doesn't know when it's going to be or how long.
Unpredictable.
So my wife and I never work at the same time. That was a rule we had. We never away from each other or the kids for more than 2 weeks. Never have been. And even that is hard, as you know. Although I'll be honest, one or two nights. That's all the I remember ringing my wife, and I was on a press tour, and I was staying in this fantastic hotel, and I rang her, and she goes, how's everything? I said, babe, please don't take this the wrong way, but it's fantastic. I said, what do you mean? I said, because she likes the curtains open, I like them closed. She has the TV on, I have it off. I said, I'm just in bed. People are all going out to party, and I'm just lying in bed on my own. She says, trust me, I get it.
And then go out to party after.
And on the wall, we have this... We have a schedule, like a calendar for the week, written up so that everybody knows what is going on. We all know what each other's lives are because, as you know, the city can get crazy busy, you know. And the other thing we learned probably when my son was about 3 was to allow a half hour extra than what we think. Mm-hmm. And if you have that luxury of time, it changes your life. And all of a sudden the city becomes phenomenal and not
rushed.
Like this beast, that this enemy. Sometimes the city can feel a bit like, I've got to keep, you know, but when you have time and you're not rushed, it's phenomenal, you know.
So who's got a question for Mr. Chen?
In a public school, my daughter's in a private school.
Okay, do you see yourself being here up until college stage when you have the option of having them being educated in Sydney?
My son is 11, so up until he was 9, he was pretty much homeschooled. If we were somewhere for 6 months, he would go into school. And then I realized that wasn't supporting him, he needed to go. So that's why we settled here. Mm-hmm. I know a lot of actors who base their family in one spot and they will go off and act and come back. I just couldn't come to that idea of being away for 4 or 5 months. Mm-hmm. I was like, I love acting, but not that much, you know. It seemed too long to be away. But I understand. You were first, yes.
Quick.
Journalist.
I know.
Why don't you guys announce yourself?
Yes, I am. So my name is Linda Grant. My site is nycsinglemom.com.
Right.
I am a single mom who adopted on their own. So at 11 days old. So I know that your kids are adopted.
They are,
so
yes.
When she was younger, it was not a big... Kids were like, oh, you're adopted, that's cool. But now it's like, you're adopted. And they're a little bit meaner than they used to be. So I'm curious as if your kids have experienced that, or if you've, you know, had any advice?
No, I mean, we talked a lot. We always were open from the beginning with both our kids about it. In fact, there's been a couple of times where I've heard my kids say, you know, I'm adopted, like, hey, I'm special.
Oh, yeah, it's cool, yeah.
You know, so, but I think the school, we talk a lot to the teachers, we talk to the headmistress. The school that my daughter's at, Little Red School House, is very progressive, and they are really active in talking with teachers, because what you don't realize, it's so easy, in every class they say, oh, we're having family day, let's talk about our families, and blah, 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 and a lot of adopted kids can all of a sudden start to feel different, for the first time start to feel they're not included. And so I think sometimes being proactive with teachers and just say, look, if there's any way, I'd like to know what you're teaching, social studies or history or family, is there a way we can bring this up in a positive framework and the idea that there are families made up in many different ways now.
Well, that's why I live in New York. There's so many adopted kids
here. Gay parents. Yeah. There's so many different things, and that's all to be celebrated and not to be seen.
That's great that you're being proactive. Thank you.
Yeah, I think you need to be. Yeah. And some schools are more on it than others. So.
I'm Mitch, gaynycdad.com.
Hey, Mitch.
My son also adopted at birth in class with her daughter and doesn't talk about it at all ever because he's a boy and doesn't notice anything as far as adoption.
Right.
But I wanted to ask, what's your favorite vacation spot with the kids in the Northern Hemisphere?
Yes, because I was going to say Byron Bay in Australia. Turks and Caicos.
Oh, I love it!